not only him individually, but then what he brings to the team as a whole. And it really has unlocked Carrion as well. Ooh. And you're seeing it already. He's going to dunk it in himself. It was dancing on the goal line and drops in for him.
Oh, that's such a nice little play. You can see he saves his flip to make sure he gets that bouncing double tap. What a...
Shown the full extent of maybe their potential, but you know it's there.
Yeah, definitely. And I mean, earlier on in the bracket, you can see how both these teams fared against their opponents. But coming out, we've got Oli. Look at that air dribble from Lewis to get it all the way off the backboard and set up his teammate. That was the best way to set that up, Corelli.
It just goes to show being that first defender and finding that back wall is so important on an attack.
Yeah.
And for Lewis to find
trouble a little bit. That's what Triple Trouble has been doing, is finding those spots on the backboard. And if nobody's on the backboard or even in the net, it doesn't matter. Just put this one on target. You're going to get a free one.
And Carrion did his best to try and beat the first man. Oli just dunks it away, wow. And it happens to go right towards Rick's Rondé. And nobody
on the rotations is all three players from Wolves, and they are matching that aggression from Carrion and Tox. And what a touch then from Tox. Corelli, this is what we talked about. Opening up space and creating plays. This is why he's such a good pickup for this team.
Yeah, it's such a smart touch from
Tox. I think that was going in anyway.
It might. Only now to help out. Lewis is there. Can he put it across? He does. Over to Rick's Rondé. Delays the shot. Follow-up from Lewis is there. Left side shot off the post and in. It crawls in for Wolves, and they retake the lead.
It's all about that delay. You can see Rick's Rondé actually hit the brakes and then went for a demo. And I'm watching his perspective. I thought maybe on his way out of the net, he was going to get in the defensive side. There's a lot of infield passing coming out from Wolves, which I'm loving. But if Solary can start reading those and intercept them, and also do a bit of their own, because this infield pass all the way from Carrion on the other side, that's what you want to see out of an infield pass.
On the money.
Oh,
perfect
yeah.
Pass to Tox. You cannot ask.
We've got overtime, Corelli.
Yeah, back and forth game here, Turtle. 11 shots for Solary to the 8 of Wolves. And they might score on their 9th. It will be only 5 seconds into overtime. Wolves take game 1.
They are threading the needle. It's small moments like this. And Oli, the positional awareness to be on the left side of that 50. While it does seem like Solary had the better talks with the early shot on net, maybe that was the key, putting something on a bit earlier. But still, somebody is there and in position for the save, but nobody's ready for the Tox follow-up. After this attempt on net, Lewis tried to get the clear, a bad 50, and Ricks actually bumped into Lewis going into that challenge.
Yeah, and final seconds here. Exotic trying to push it across. And again, Tox is up. He's going to find the back wall. Carrion's up. No one's up. Only he's got to make the save. He does. Exotic can't get there. And Rick's Rondé is going to clear it down the field. Solary, get one back. Only great fake. Just got Exotic to beat, and Exotic shuts him down. Exotic still on the ball. Low boost. Can he put it on target? He will slip it by. You talk about transition for Wolves, but it's Solary on the transition to find the first goal.
By himself, it's Exotic. Nice little flick to keep it to himself. And then he realized, it was going for a dribble. Carrion trying to get a dunk. And Exotic, he's so fast to keep this ball in. Look at that challenge from Exotic. Instantly up in the air. Corelli wins the 50 and sets his team up.
Carrion gets a piece in on his challenge. Then Exotic comes through. Tox to finish it off. The inside of the post helping him out.
And there still are some chances for Solary to crack that defense. They're going to need to pick up the pace. I think their rotation's out of net. Too slow. Nobody's on the backboard for this. The goalkeeper didn't even want to try to pre-jump it. And you can see how deadly this Solary offense is with Tox. The double tap from the corner, drop down. A lot of added pressure. Lewis now going for the dribble, but Carrion gets bumped. That's what we needed. Some kind of physicality to add on to those dribbles, and it works out. Wolves, now it's a 2-goal game for them.
Look at Rick's Rondé here. Didn't even think about going for the ball, and instead crushes that last defender.
One opponent, win the 1v1. Now Oli doing the same thing, but he's not fast enough to get the recovery.
Oh,
maybe the follow-up
no
on the
way.
Backboard. It's not
going
to get saved. It does fall in. There was a slight chance, but in the end, too much power was on that ball.
I honestly thought it was going to get saved.
Yeah.
Carrion was right there. He was half.
Big save from Oli. He had no boost going for that save. Still found a double jump touch and got it to his teammate. Now trying to get another hit on Exotic's shot. This was a tough angle, but definitely some good security for everyone on Solary.
And this is great positioning from Exotic. So he comes from his own back right boost. Off the back wall, Carrion, tough read. He does get the touch. He will put it to the corner. And that will secure this game. Solary up to Exotic again. I think he wanted to play that one to Tox, who was coming off the ceiling. Instead, got a back hit. Only by himself. Plays it over the defense in the first goal to Wolves.
It's about time one of these dribbles, ends up working. Only the whole team gets beaten here. Two defenders flicked past each
other. Lewis again on the sideline, not letting Solary out that easy, but it's Exotic to pick it up into the air. Tox is there to help. Takes the shot. Takes it away from Exotic and ties up the game.
Oh, a nice little pre-dump. You love to see these happen. Tox was already in the air. He saw Exotic. He knew where Exotic.
Now 2v1, Carrion tries to get by Oli. And now Tox plays it by, and Wolves are going to get the goal and send us to game five.
And this is why you don't challenge the 1v1 player, the guy who's always going for the dribbles, Oli, on the other side, because he's going to win that challenge and then continue forward to get the shot on net out of Solary, who seemed to be the most dominant team so far in game five. That's one for Exotic, but Rondé again, another crucial hit for his team.
Tox. Yep. Perfect shot from Tox. You could feel it coming. Solary had the entirety of Wolves mixed up on top of the goal line. Tox had free range at the top of the box to put that one away.
It's Rondé. I've noticed he's the one player on Wolves who isn't afraid to go into the other side, take some corner boost, for a cheeky little shot like this one from Lewis. I think that one would have eventually crossed the goal line, but Oli's there for the secure hit.
Oh, Exotic.
Wow.
Runs into Carrion and they don't get the best touch. Oli. And quickly, Exotic, who's to work with? Has Tox, he's gonna go. Tox gets the touch, top shelf, makes amends for his mistake before and wins the series.
And I'm getting deja vu. It's Exotic again. Nice little air dribble. Tox is up so early to receive that ball, knows exactly where.